What's going on, YouTube? Cootie here with entry number 79, I believe? 78, somewhere in there. Missing Friday kind of threw me off, which is really odd because I'm actually recording this on Friday. So it's really, really odd. But missing the video on Friday didn't throw me off. I do apologize for that, guys. I'm not going to lie, I've had some... I guess you'd consider it creator's block. I've got the next so many entries planned out, planned out in a notebook and everything. But there's just this small gap in between getting to that that I was having some issues with. But I figured out something really good to do today. And we'll get on with that here in just a few minutes. But first things first, I went to the Nether. I tried recording for Friday's entry multiple times. I went to the Nether, tried to find a new fortress with a double, double blaze spawner. I wanted to move the blaze spawner farm over there to a double one, get a lot of drops that way. Could not find one, ended up dying, but I got all my stuff back except my bow. We got version 6. The last thing it needs is flame put on it to have our good bow back. Everything else was still there. I got cornered by a couple of wither scalies in just a small room, and they wrecked my face. It's so weird though. They had my sword and my clothes on, my armor on, but my bow was completely gone. Just odd. So yep, that happened. And then when I couldn't find one, I decided, hey, we'll come back here and work on the next super chunk. I don't know what else I want to put in there outside of the potion brewing, auto potion brewing area. And I tried Tangotech's design, built it on a creative world and everything, and I don't think it works in the newest snapshot. So, issues. Of course, I mean, there's probably a fix for it. I may have messed something up, but by the time I got done with all of that, I just really didn't have time to record and decided, no, we're just not going to worry about it today. Now, let me show y'all something real quick, and I'll show you what we're going to be working on. We just head off in this direction. It's not too far, and is that going down or coming up? I can never remember. Oh well, we're going this way. Grab some more of these. Right over here is this village. I'd forgot about this village. But more important is, right over here is a witch hut. And I think it's far past time that we get ourselves a witch farm going. I think this will do just fine. Gotta say goodbye to the village. There was not much there anyway. So, we're gonna tear down the village. We're gonna get rid of all of this, flatten it out, and we're gonna have ourselves a witch hut. A, fully auto witch farm. We're gonna go with El Mango's design. Yeah. He posted a video about 2 months ago on this design, and I highly recommend it. I just finished building it in the test world. Wanted to make sure it worked on the new snapshot and stuff. And boy does it. It is absolutely amazing. So, link is down in the description if you're interested in it. I'm going to head back to this way. Which way am I going again? I think it's this way. Yeah, this way. We're going to head back over here, get what we need to build it, because it's not really expensive. I've got everything we need to build it, which I'm excited about. We're going to grab the stuff, and I'll be right back with you. All right, guys, we're back, and I don't know what I was thinking. We have absolutely no reason to tear down this village. The whole farm fits within this little area right here, and we are going to need a few little boxes out here to get started. But we're going to have to do some work here. This is going to be fun. Now I've got to, one, tear this down. Let's go ahead and grab some blocks real quick. Let me see here. 2, 3, 4. No, I don't need a crafting table yet. I will, but not quite yet. Grab us some stone bricks. And let's grab our axe. And I'm going to go ahead and mark out this is going to be the roof of the farm. We're gonna go ahead and get this marked that way I don't forget where it's at. And the roof actually comes out to right here, so we can just place that one. No, I missed. I tried. Let's head back up and try this again. There we go. Boom. 7 by 9 by 7. That's all it's gonna take. So we got that in. All that's left now is to completely destroy this thing, clear out the water, and then dig down an additional 32 blocks for them to fall to their death. Easy, right? Yeah. So no better way to do that than a nice third-person time lapse. You know, after doing super chunks, this thing was nothing. This didn't take any time at all. I was so prepared for so much more, and we didn't even fill up the first one. But that's okay. Let's get on with it. Let's get a move on. Get this thing working. Let's see here. This is the bottom of our farm. The whole thing is literally 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7 blocks. Well, 8 blocks because you got the roof. But that's it. 8 blocks worth. So, let's see here. Let me go over here. I got people messaging me and it's. Don't they know I'm trying to record? Oh well. That's okay. Let's just head up here. And for right now, I'm only going to build a small roof. I'm going to completely cover it and make it nice and dark so we have spawn rates pretty consistently. All this is inside. I really like how compact this design is. It is super simple to build. If I can build it, anybody can build it, one of those kinds. So, there we go. To think everything about this farm. Well, there's some redstone there. I will say there is some redstone. It'll stick out the back. But for the most part, the entire farm is within this little 7 by 9 by 7 area. And I think that is absolutely epic. And to get the spawn rates. Oops. Nope. Hey. There we go. To get the spawn rates this thing does in such a small area is just mind-boggling. So there's our roof. Now we're gonna go ahead and fill in this. I'm not gonna worry about that. I'm not gonna worry about that right now. We'll work on that later on. Probably make an item elevator coming up right in this area to collect everything. Yeah, I think that'll work. So let me go ahead and start working on getting this knocked out. We don't need that anymore. Nor do I need that. All right. I'm gonna have to knock this out because we're gonna need a little extra room here on the sides. One, two, three. Let me go ahead and grab over here. Grab our slime blocks because we is gonna need some slime blocks going. One, two, three. Oh, I forgot these things break so easily. One, two. Arrgh. I keep misplacing blocks. I am literally the king of the misplaced block. That's all there is to it. Me knock out this stuff. Because it's pretty particular. It really is about how you go about doing some of this. Let me get down below here. Knock some of this out as well. Let's just give ourselves some maintenance room. I'm a big fan of maintenance room. Having plenty of room to get everything you need done. Big fan. Knock all this out. And then we'll fill it back in later on. I guess y'all noticed I went and got my beacon. I figured, more digging, let's go get the beacon. And I kind of lost it. It wasn't in my ender chest where I normally leave it. And it was not back where we were digging. So I was a little worried. Found it inside our super chunk there. Inside one of the chests inside. It was. Issues. So, yep. This is pretty much the whole floor design right here. Meaning I'm probably going to need to knock out that little bit over there as well. Then, right in the middle, we put a full thing of regular ones. I probably should have made this bigger. Wasn't thinking about that at the time. Two, three. Three. And then we head over here. Two, three. One, two, three. There we go. And that's it. That's the whole first floor. I will take a sleep real quick. We're going to end up building three of these floors for them to spawn on. So I'll get that done, get some of the stuff around the edges taken care of, and just kind of get it all molded where it needs to be. And we'll be back here in just a few minutes. Alrighty, guys. We got a couple platforms in. I had to do a little bit of readjusting, not much. I moved that layer down one, and I moved the ceiling up one. And yeah, that should take care of everything. And we got some sticky pistons here. Let me jump down here real quick. I'm going to take out some more of this around the edges eventually. But for the moment, it's going to come in kind of handy. And yeah. I've already fell down there once. I really didn't want to do it again. So let me grab some scaffolding blocks here. I don't know if that's going to work too well. Let's do it from up here. Even then, it's not exactly the best. But hey, you got to work with what you got. We need some sticky pistons underneath of here. Probably one of those things I could have done before I dug out the big massive hole underneath. That may have probably should have been the last step. But hey, where's the fun in that? Oh. Those are just so hard to come by. Oh, come on, really? Right there. There we go. So we can just knock all this out. The scaffolding block. Go through, tear this out. Because we don't need those slime blocks touching anything else. We'll take some of our stone bricks, combine those, and redstone it. Simple enough, right? Oh, that don't go there. And let's go ahead and do the next one. That way I can move on with the entry. I'll do it this way instead of making y'all watch me go through all of them. That would be, in my opinion, quite boring. Some of this. There we go. One of those. One of these. One of. Forgot where I was going there. One of those and one of these. Now, this should produce more than enough redstone and glowstone to easily make up for what we don't get in the other mob farm. The other mob farm produces so much of everything else. This one should take care of the redstone and glowstone for us. There we go. And then one more right here. Boom. Now, with that being done, we can go ahead and add in our observer blocks. Let me see here. They are actually going to need to move into this mountainside here, so let's dig out a little bit of that. I know it doesn't seem like I'm prepared, very prepared, and I'm really probably not because, well, I'm Kuya. That's just kind of what I do. But we went over. I watched the tutorial on how he did this, and we both he did it in an open, a void world, and I did it in a testing world. So I don't need this right here knocked out. But again, I like to have a maintenance room. There we go. So we're going to want to connect all of this stuff up. Wonder why there's nothing spawning. I'm sure I'm far enough away. That's a little irksome. Oh well, we'll figure that out later. Back down here. Now this is what we're going to do. Well, what we're doing right now is we're going to connect up all of our redstone lines here using observer blocks. Really like the way he did this. Blocks there and there. Bring these three down, and then nope. Get over here. Whew. I don't think that one goes that way. It needs to go directly down. There we go. And then there. Then we can place this redstone back, that way it doesn't detect it. And these are already hooked up. This side is hooked up. We'll hook up that side over there, doing the exact same thing. And then I'll build my last platform and get it hooked up over here on this side, so it's above the water. And we'll get into the last little bit of redstone for this thing. So I'll see y'all here in just a minute. Alright, guys. Finally got it all into place and everything. It's pretty self-explanatory. We're gonna have the clock up here. Now, according to his video, I looked it up on the wiki and stuff and made sure everything was pretty well still the same. The witch will spawn. You got about 25 seconds to activate it, so it needs to activate every 25 seconds because they have a chance of despawning after 30 seconds, or they will despawn after 30 seconds. So we'll have our clock going out the back there, and it will activate the redstone here, which will update that observer block and carry the signal down and down. So that's pretty self-explanatory, and it's going to activate the pistons, pushing them each up and then bringing them back down. And what that's going to do is it's going to glitch each layer of witches, all three layers. It'll glitch them down, and then they will fall down to the very bottom. And of course, they will fall to their death. We've made it far enough so they will fall. Thought about, or you can't. I didn't even think about it. I actually did smart stuff this time. You can't do the magma blocks down there. They'll just use fire resistance potions and different things. So they have to fall to their death. Make sure it's insta death, and we'll create an item elevator coming up probably right here, and storing all of our stuff. But now we need to go back in here and use some of these leaf blocks, because we don't want anything else being able to spawn, like spiders and stuff. So we need one in between each of these, because these blocks right here are spawnable. So we need to put some leaves right here, and then at the same time, let me grab a stack of dirt. I don't want to waste the leaves we got. Put some right here as well, because the slime blocks will not pull them or push them. So that right there will take care of all of that. Head over here and do the exact same thing. And we'll also use leaves here on the sides to keep the witches from falling out the side, keeping them from pushing each other out. In the test world, it's kind of funny. I really wish I was kind of recording it. There's some redstone. Grab that. Words. Why are words so hard? I did this, and one of the witches spawned on the outside, fell over to the side. It was fine. I created a big hole straight down to the void, so every time I flip the button, they just fall straight on down. And one fell on the outside, and I got a fence around a cobblestone wall. I broke the wall, and the witch just ran in, like full steam ahead, dive bombed straight down the hole. It was hilarious. Why that has to do with absolutely anything, not a clue. But figured y'all needed to know. So I'm gonna get the rest of our leaf blocks in, and I'll be right back with you. Alright, guys. We've got it all taken care of. I think we've got pretty much everything blocked off with the leaves and the stuffs and the stuffs. So our next step is to make sure we're on this top layer right here. Not the roof, but the top spawning floor. And you're going to take this redstone line right here and connect all the way around. Like so. Leave that spot open for the moment. All the way with that one. And we're going to put our timer in here. We're going to go with a comparator timer, because according to Elmango, that is more reliable at the moment. The hopper timer, the Etho hopper clock, it still has an issue with sometimes duplicating things. So we're going to go with the comparator clock. And to do so, we need an observer right here. And you can go ahead and place that redstone right there now. We just wanted it there to begin with, which I don't guess it matters too much, but you never know. Grab some repeaters, and one repeater inside of this one. Let me grab the old camera account on my test world real quick. I'll make sure I've got this right. We need it on three ticks of delay, and it is going into a monostable circuit. So let's go ahead and grab our sticky piston. I big fan of these circuits here lately, especially dealing with observer blocks. And then we need another, let's see here, Let me do it from I think I want to do it from this side. One here, block there. And then we need a comparator running into this block with a lever right here. This is just going to give us the power we need. Don't need it quite yet, but we're going to. We are going to end up needing it. Now from this block right here, we need a repeater facing, let's see, from this comparator. Need a repeater. This is quite confusing because what I got on my test road is backwards compared to this one. So it's a little strange, not gonna lie. So we need two repeaters, one coming into this comparator and one facing out of this block. We need the one facing out. We're gonna need a redstone line here. We need a block here. Then we can run our actual comparator clock here. There we go. Let me go ahead and get our redstone dust down here to connect the two. The two lines need eight on each side. That needs to be on subtract mode. And I believe that's it. I believe that's it. We will see right here. Well, you know, it does make a big difference. Let me flip that off. When you take this, I got one left. Wow. How are we gonna do this? Guess I'm gonna have to leave this one open. Oh well. Put it this way. There we go. We're gonna have to leave that one open. I'm out of leaves. I know I could get some, but where's the fun in that? Now. Perfect. So what that's gonna do is it's gonna allow the switches to spawn on each layer, and then it's going to push them down, and they're going to fall to their death. So all that's left is hooking up the different system or the collection system down below, running it into an item elevator right here, and yeah, that's gonna be it. Let me go ahead and get that taken care of. Y'all have seen that a couple of times now, so I'm not gonna worry about recording it. I'm just gonna do the same old thing I do all the time down there. And we'll get this hooked up, and I'll be right back with you. Alrighty, guys. I know I wasn't gonna show you this, but I decided, hey, why not? Pretty standard stuff. I dug it down a couple more just to be safe. And yeah, pretty standard. Lots of hoppers, as always. I use a ton of hoppers. Probably shouldn't, but I do. So, but instead of doing like magma blocks and stuff, we can just stick with doing some upside down slabs here. It'll collect through these, and at the same time keep other things from spawning down here. But I think I'll leave the torches just because. I mean, it's not gonna hurt anything. But this should do just fine. See, you drop it, it automatically collects. And there it is. I was about to say, where did it go? Where did it go, George? Where did it go? Old school, right there. Yeah, but this is gonna cover it for today. Again, I apologize for not having one for Friday. That it's just one of those deals where it's like, I don't know what to do. I've got so many things going on that I honestly just did not know the best course of action. Didn't know the best course of action to go with. That should be good. So let's just pillar our way up right here. And like I said, there's a lot of little things I want to do. I want to get that potion brewery stand going because I want to be able to do potions for the Guardian Temple. Ow. Yeah, you're hurting. You know what? You're not the only one with a bow there, buddy. How are you not dead yet? Just go. Yep, I want to do the two. Oh, jump straight back into things here. I want to go, I want to get the Guardian farm going. I don't want you around. Good to know where mobs still work. So, want the Guardian Farm, want the potions to do the Guardian Farm, want the Blaze Farm to do the potion brewing, auto potions. There've been just so many little things, and I'm having such a hard time finding exactly what we need. So, yeah, it's just been an issue. But guys, I'm going to go ahead, finish up right here. All that's left, all we're going to do now is, I'm going to enclose this thing. Nothing big and fancy. It's just going to, we'll probably build like a little house around it to make it look nice. We might do that next entry. Yeah, we'll save that for next entry. Finish up the other thing here. Words. Item elevator. Get the storage area done. And different things like that. So, guys, that's going to be it for today. That's the plans for next time. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button for me. I'd really appreciate it. It does help out the channel. If you really, really enjoyed, which I don't know why you would, consider subscribing to the channel to keep up to date with all the latest Minecraft stuff. Got all kinds of things going on there. You can find me on Twitter. Best place to keep in contact with me. Know when things are coming out, what's going on, all that different stuff. Just to say hi. And you can find me streaming on Beam.pro. Really enjoying that. Looking forward to where that takes us. So many things going on right now. Cannot thank everybody enough for the support on there. So come on out, hang out with us, and you know the rest. Have fun, be good. We'll see y'all next time.